Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Crusader Kings, where we've got this awkward rebellion going on where it's kind of hard to see what's going on. But this is who we're fighting against, and it doesn't show up. I've even restarted the game at this point. I got nothing. But we're going to beat them. The question is, will we do it before this guy dies? He's 71. He's in poor health, but he is athletic, so he might last a while longer. His son is unlikely to last a while at this point. So we need to remember that. We're also up against the Northmen, who are declaring on this yet again. We're just going to go ahead and call our allies in to the Northmen conquest. I'm not sure that we're going to call them into the Caperite Uprising. Can we even call this guy into the Caperite Uprising? I mean, we can call her in. She's our wife. And that explains it, but I'm just going to call her into the Northmen. Okay. And we can create titles. We can negotiate alliances. We're not going to do that at this time. We can demand ransom payments. All of that is things that we can do. But what we're wanting to do right now, let's just select all of our armies and let's just get a sense of what's going on. So these guys are still making their way in over here. These guys are coming into slow siege. These guys and these guys are grouping up over this way, presumably going to bring in these guys as well. We're going to need some resupply at some point. It is the 7th of July, but I would like to defeat all of these. Who is the war leader and where is he at? He is in this army. They're going to take over this fort in Ryazan. And once they do, I believe our ticking war score might be gone at that point. They shouldn't get ticking war score yet, but it may well be gone by then. We do have a dangerous faction brewing here, and this is an independence faction. And that needs to be dealt with. And peasants in 2 months as well? Yikes. Okay, so what do we want to do with this guy? I doubt that we can do anything, really. Yeah, we kind of can't. Okay. We don't have a ton of options here right now. So how do we want to get around this? We could demand conversion on this guy. Odds are low. 150 gold for 62 opinion. Now, he's really angry about the offensive wars. Fair enough. That's mostly things that only people who are not Tengri are going to be mad about. Here's the question. Do we think that we can beat them? I mean, yeah, we can. But we can we beat all of these simultaneously? Things would actually be far easier if we were to die. We don't have any real option for that. Okay. We should definitely call her into the Caperite Uprising. 641, 622, 494. None of those are really likely to do too much. We have a lot of payments we can demand. House head hooks. Okay. 1038. So about 6 months until we can extort subjects. Hmm. 25 gold. And I think we'll just go through here. He has no gold. That's not going to be helpful. 50 gold. Oh, this is going to be annoying. It goes up to the top every time. Okay. Well, we're going to get a good amount of gold here. And that gold will be important. We're going to need it. So let's get all of this payment done. This guy doesn't have enough gold. That's okay. As long as he has some gold, we will take it. We've got a little bit of desperation going on here. Now, there's potentially a few other options. We can try to create a truce with the leader of the faction, the Independence faction. So that netted us a decent amount of gold. Fantastic. Okay, so who is the leader of the faction? Let's see here. This guy. He is a duke. I don't suppose it'll let me do this. This is hilarious. He's your problem now. Get out of here. Okay. This guy will leave the faction. Yep. Faction disbanded. That was populists. Okay. So this guy is now leader of the faction. Okay, what can we do about this guy? He is Caberite. What would a gift net us? 106 opinion. He also wants a seat on the council. 225 gold for 106 opinion isn't awful. What's he good at? He's an okay diplomat. I'll allow it. So that's this guy. We can't put him in. This guy is blocked from being removed from the council. Okay, so what else could we do with this guy? I don't want to replace our marshal. I suppose I could replace our spymaster, but he's a powerful vassal. We could replace our steward. It's not great, but I'm going to put him in there. That boosts the opinion dramatically. Next, we're going to send him the gift. That boosts him up to 61 opinion. 43% chance on the conversion. Can we boost his opinion anymore? Is that tribal coming back to bite us a bit? Not shocking. Not rightful liege. Interesting. Presumably because we didn't create the Empire title. Fair enough. We did that specifically so that it didn't get lost in High Partition. However, this isn't going to create a truce. We don't have any more children that we can utilize. At least, not for right now. So he's at 61 opinion of us. And there's not really a lot more that we can do about that. Indeed. I mean, we could give him a vassal of some type. But maybe we just roll the dice here. 42% chance? Let's see how it goes. It's going to be spicy, no doubt about it. Okay, that's a ransom acceptance. He wants a hook. Desperate times, desperate measures. I accept. I don't like it, but I'll accept it. Now he should leave the faction. He's at max opinion, and he does have a hook on us. So there is that. And now we could arrange a marriage here. Unfortunately, granddaughters do not count. I really wish that they did. But they don't. So, other options. I want to force the alliance here. And we can't just negotiate the alliance with him, sadly. Well, betrothal broken. Okay, buddy. Let's do this. alliance formed, he will disband that faction. Now, someone else will almost certainly create the faction. Ryazan is now under their control, and we actually didn't lose the ticking war score. I'm shocked. But okay. That sounds good to me. No sign of the Northmen yet. They will turn up. Somewhere. For now, we're more interested in dealing with this. Okay, there goes the war score from held objectives. So yeah, ticking war score is against us now. We need to get up over here, and we're working on it. We're embarking over here. And there is, of course, another faction here, but this is just the peasants. For now, that's okay. How many unraised troops do we have? About 1,000. Noted. Okay, these guys are here. These guys are still a long ways away. We are getting these slow sieges started, but we haven't ticked very far. I don't feel like we want to call a hunt right now. There's the Northmen. Punjabi populace just disbanded. Okay. Would they accept a white piece? Not currently. Okay. Ooh, I like this. I like what's going on up here. Yes, keep fighting people that are neutral to us. Okay, this guy popped. We're not surprised by this. Honestly? Should we grant them a tax lien? No. A peasant's lot is to serve their lord. So, we're going to come over here, see what they've got. That should be over this way. Okay. We're going to raise up in our capital anybody who isn't currently raised. And we're also maybe going to hire a merc group. Yes. Okay. We'll let this tick until there's a few. Okay, 27. We need about 1,000. Although, honestly, this is probably enough. Yeah, I'm going to say this is enough. In we go. We'll deal with these guys. Fresh converts have volunteered. Okay. And we'll get that sorted out. Then there's this over here. We'll be able to deal with that, no problem. Where are these guys at? They have arrived here. We're going to split them. And we're going to send some of them up over here. Yeah, they'll take attrition on the way. But they should reinforce, in theory, as well. And then we'll send some over here. These guys, they're going to come up over here as well. And these guys are going to come up as well. Okay. So this battle was won. That is not surprising. Not this battle here. Not sure where the other battle is. But we'll deal with these peasants, no problem. We'll come in over here, deal with them as well. These guys are a bit of an issue, to be sure. Our son is no longer afflicted by consumption. You know what? We could stop and siege here. And I think that's a non-terrible idea. We have finished up our battle here. These guys are going to walk over and deal with that. Okay. We don't really have a plan in place for dealing with the Northmen at this time. They're slow sieging. I'd like to get these guys wiped out first. Let's go ahead and split this in half so that we can resupply while we're waiting for our reinforcements to walk in. These guys, I'm going to just check here. Let's have them come up over this way. Like so. They're getting close. Wonderful. How's our peasants getting handled? Words are difficult. Yeah, the Siege of Tula is lost. We're not surprised by that. We're getting in position for this war. We were wildly out of position. For this up here as well, in all honesty. Okay. She died. Doesn't really matter, though. Okay, we're going to come in here, deal with these peasants. No problem. And how are things going over this way? This siege will be in 4 months. And we have forces arriving up here. Good. Now we're going to lose this, which is not great. We may end up overall losing this area because of the timing there. That guy left the Khazar Khabarite Uprising. Okay. We have finished up our battle with the peasants, and we're going to go in over here. Okay. Our granddaughter was taken prisoner. That's rude. Very rude indeed, but we are arriving, and this siege will be finishing up shortly. We're just going to keep sieging down over here, I feel like. This is, of course, the Khabarite Uprising, and we definitely need to deal with that. Okay, as these troops start arriving, we will fight these guys. This is a higher priority than this war. How are things going with the peasants? That'll be done. Okay. Siege 1, down over here. And we are going to go siege at Azov. So that netted us a little bit of war score. We're going to bring all of these guys up over here. Sanctioned war declaration is what he went with. You know what? That's okay. I don't mind that. We're going to group up everybody up over here, including these guys. And we're getting very close here. Yeah, we're not surprised by this. We'll turn on them later. After we've dealt with this problem. Okay. Here we are arriving up here. That's our war against the peasants dealt with. This is bugged. That's our war with the peasants dealt with. Excellent. And now we will get these guys disbanded. And I believe we can teleport over the mercenaries. Let's test that. So we're going to move the rally point to here, I guess we'll do. That was a weird... There we go. And then these guys... Yeah, they can just be teleported on over. Hilarious. Hop on in. We're grouping everybody up over here. We just won a battle. Where? Where was this? Oh, this over here. That's fine. Honestly, I feel like we don't need these guys, but they're going to make for some good reinforcements once they make their way up here slowly. Mercenary contracts are expiring, and we need to get in there, though. Go. Go now. Okay. We won a siege, and that was this down over here, I believe. Actually, no. That would have been our slow sieges happening over here. Wonderful. You can go siege there, and where else? It's like over here. Right? Right. Honestly, you can chase down this force. Okay. So we're going to give battle here, and this will be kind of the big battle of this war. Let's see how that goes. They are running away. Stack wipe. Beautiful. We're going to let them lock in here if they do. Okay, they're not locking in. We're going to head up over this way. These guys are going to continue moving along behind. And we're going to go in. We have died. Okay, so this death is actually fairly convenient. The rebellion, the Khazarite Uprising... Or the Khabarite Uprising is gone. However, this is a new one. a new Khazarite uprising that instantly popped. Okay. Well, that's interesting, isn't it? We don't have those allies anymore, right? We don't have a lifestyle either. For right now, we're just going to go with scholarship focus. Okay, we need counselors. We'll put in the most qualified but powerful vassals. Like so. So we know that there's going to be dangerous factions happening. Our player heir has no spouse, and apparently the phone is ringing. Please stop that. Excellent. And let's see here. We could go with a robust person. That'll be fine. We'll do that. Okay, and what else do we have going on here? I mean, we have this independence faction. This guy, we can simply negotiate an alliance with. No problem. What else do we have? That's it. Okay. This is interesting. They're fighting our populists for us. I like it. You pop down over here. These guys, they are going to group up. Okay. So there's that faction gone for right now. Now there's a bunch of locations under siege. We're not shocked by this. We are now going to head over to Hrodna, I think. Where's their leadership at? Oh, this is awkward. Our ally is not in these wars, I guess. We'll call him in. There we go. And we'll call him into the Northman army conquest as well. We also forgot to siege this. There we go. And there is a faction. We're not surprised by this. This guy. He is Tengri. No problem. There's that sorted. Excellent. Alliance has been formed. Can he be called in? No. He's a vassal. So that's not going to be a thing. These guys are walking in down over here. And where is their leadership at? Over here. Okay. Let's see about dealing with that. Fantastic. We can also host a feast and call a hunt. We're going to go ahead and host a feast right now. And this guy is the current issue. But now it's not an issue at all. For the moment. We're at 3 of 5 domain holdings, and we will need to deal with this. We'll need to take this back. But for now, that's not a priority. Okay. There we go. And yeah, our mercenary contract is expiring, but for now, that will be fine. We're going to come up over here. Yes, we do have another dangerous faction. That's not shocking in the slightest. We knew there would be some issues like this. So this guy is manageable, actually. Assuming we don't have any sons. We do. Only the one. Okay. Well, this isn't going to solve the problem right away, but we can do something like that. So this guy is definitely the problem that we need to deal with. That is slightly problematic. Siblings. We do have this half-brother and half-sister. We break this betrothal. And then That doesn't net us an alliance? I'm actually surprised by that. I expected a half-sister to net an alliance. Huh. Fascinating. These options are very limited. Okay. 7 months on that independence faction, that's fine. It is, however, about time to put a cut in here, so I'm going to go ahead and do that, and next episode, we'll see how we can handle this situation. You can leave your offerings to the engagement gods in the form of likes, comments, subscribes, and bell ringings, and I will see you all next time.